as we get ready for this puck to be dropped on a Saturday night. Basingstoke Bisons visit the Swindon Wildcats, and we start with Aaron Nell, Sam Bullis, and Jonas Hoog starting off with, again, Neil Lydiard and Jan Kostel. Jan Kostel back on the defensive area with Callum Buglis out for about 6 to 8 weeks. To Jan Kostel, Jan Kostel back to Hoog, and now get some chances here. Wildcats 5-on-3. This has got to be one of those money in the bank moments. It's back to Nell. Nell takes his time. He then just turns it through. Big save, Berlossi. Get the paddle down in the leg. Again, these typical European goalies. Very big, very flexible, very strength-oriented. Basingstoke go down to 5-on-4. Puck stays in. Picked up by Jonas Hoog. Hoog down to Malazinski. He sees his player. Jan Kostel had it teed up. Back to Nell. Big save by Herlowski. Loose play. Jan Kostel. Long pass to Jonas Hoog. Jonas Hoog comes back into them. Mark Smith picks up the play, and Aaron Nell just on a bit of a forecheck with Joe Barrett, ex-Swindon Wildcat. Seems like he's been around forever, but leadership. One remaining in this first period. Aaron Conley makes a line change. Got those protective covers on the skate. Sam Bullis goes wide. Big pickup from Herlovsky. Sam Bullis and Declan Bomber having a bit of a chat. This is what we want to see. Bomber's got the gloves up, and Sam Bullis gets him going quick. Looks to tee up, but Deck Bomber's hanging in there. Sam Bullis has still got the grill on. Reaching out with that left hand. Declan Bomber's taking a few, and Sam Bullis looks to change over. Good stand-up scrap from Declan Bomber and Sam Bullis, but again, Sam Bullis gets that left hand, reaches out with a jab, lands a few, and if you can't switch up from left to right, your face is going to get tattooed with a bunch of left sandwiches. But again, Sam Bullis stands up tight, good stand-up scrap. Declan Bomber does his job for the Bison again, but good work there. Don't need to talk about it, let's get the gloves off. For the loose puck, cross ice pass from Jan Kostel. Jan Kostel over to Lydiard. Lydiard plays it into the middle of the ice. Loose play, Sean Thompson on the forecheck. Picked up from Stevie Law. Stevie Law gets out of that net and lays it around to Floyd Taylor. Comes back to Declan. Derek Rowe deflected in front of the net, and Sean Thompson. Sean Thompson again gets in front of that net. Possibly looking waved off. Possible for goaltender interference on the play, but it's going to stay. And again, Stevie Log is taken out by Sean Thompson behind the net. Not pretty to watch, but he piles up the point, Sean Thompson. 18 minutes on the clock. Burrell wins the draw, comes back to Whitfield. Whitfield's got pressure, he's got time. Woody Fitter pinched on the boards, turned over in the Swindon zone to Rowell. Stevie Wilcox comes flying into second base. It looks like he's going to go for a tripping call. Comes back to the top, back out to Jarolik. Under Britter pressure from Kostel on the point. Cross ice play to Davies. Davies, a nice play. Good pass over to Yarolin. But Dan Davies reads it well. Comes back over the point to Davies. Quick pass down to Yarolin. Catches Stevie Law on the short side. Basingstoke Bison go up 2-0 to the Wildcats. 14:55 on the clock. But again, on that power play, both teams on the play, power play specialists. Wildcats take that timeout. Good timeout from now. Just as we want to make the lineup get away from it at the moment. Basingstoke break free. 2-on-1 with Jan Karpov. Jan Karpov, big save from Lyle. Big rebound, double save. Hits the deck, goes down quicker than a Michael Tyson heavyweight champion in the early 90s. Jan Kostel, Sam Bullis, Malazinski, Hoogan now. Looking for the big boys to make T1 up. Comes back to Malazinski. Unlucky in a wraparound. And again, Herlowski had it. Sits back behind the Wildcats net. They got it through from Malazinski. Malazinski in control. Under a bit of pressure from Kurt Reynolds. Kurt Reynolds turns the puck over. Malazinski still under a lot of pressure. Malazinski and Bullis. Sam Bullis looking to make a check behind the net. Sam Bullis is not having that. And Sam Bullis and Bomber are going to go again. But Bomber puts him on the deck again. He slips. Wasn't the right time for that. Right idea, but it just wasn't enough space to get the slits going. But again, Declan Bomber backdoors Malazinski, and Sam Bullis not happy with that. This feud's just simmering tonight, but again, there just wasn't enough space for it to properly kick off. Both players going to go for two. This feud's going to be simmering over it again. Malazinski still down, so we'll see how long they go off for. But again, Malazinski got backdoored by Bomber. It's got to be 2+2. Wildcats got to go in the power play here, but I don't think this Bomber Bullis feud is going to settle anytime soon. Just wasn't enough space. Bomber reacts, makes the play. Bullis comes in, but just wasn't enough space to kind of open up and start swinging. Right thing to do. You can't let your marquee players get touched like that. Good response from Sam Bullis. Goes back to Ollie Stone. Ollie Stone looks for Malazinski. Malazinski goes across into Mark Smith. Mark Smith up in the blue line. Turns it over. Good support work from Eric Rell. Comes back to Hoog. Hoog drifts to the middle. Top, and there it is. Jonas Hoog. That's the goal the Wildcats needed. Bit of traffic. Catches Hierofly by surprise. 3 minutes on the clock. That's what the Wildcats needed. They just needed that one to kind of kickstart this reply. So again, Jonas Hoog steps up on the clock. With Aronel down, they're going to need Hoog and Malazinski to deliver. Fans are up on their feet here. Voloski looks a bit rattled, but again, he's out in that net. Went top shelf easily. Catches him by surprise. Just one of those games. Is there enough time on the clock for the Wildcats to grab that second goal? Ideal opportunity. This is their bread and butter. This is what pays the rent for the Wildcats. The power play situation. This is where guys got to step up. Bad call from the linesman to make the call. Dropping the puck. Clearly people weren't ready. Loose puck in front for Sam Bullis. Could have been the hero. Goes back to Hoog. Hoog just it through. Hrlovsky takes the whistle. And that's it. Basingstoke Bisons leave the Link Center on a Saturday night.